next question is from Ma Sujata from Chennai, who is asking Nityananda Swamiji, in yesterday's satsang, you spoke about the extraordinary characterization and truthful representation of characters in the serial Devon Ke Dev Mahadev. Can you speak more about this, Swamiji? Also, whatever is shown in the serial, how much of it is philosophically true?
It's a nice question. The question is, in yesterday's satsang, you spoke about the extraordinary characterization and truthful representation of characters in the serial Devon Ki Dev. Can you speak more about this, Swamiji? Also, whatever is shown in the serial, how much of it is philosophically true? Please understand, bringing a mythological story to life is not a joke. If I put all my intelligence, philosophical strength, understanding, all my abilities and try to do a serial on Shiva, it will not be better than Devon Ki Dev, I tell you. They are doing best job. It's amazing job they are doing. There are a lot of subtle points when Devi assumes human body. What happens? There are so many subtle points, philosophical points. They are presenting so beautifully. They are neither missing the philosophical thread nor missing the storyline and making it so alive. And I tell you, in ISKCON, they give you so many movies related to Krishna with English. Subtitles. I tell you, all our devotees should watch Devon Ki Dev with English subtitles. It's the best thing they are doing to the whole Vedic tradition. See, they are able to make the whole thing alive in front of you. And even those people who are acting, they have put so much of effort into the whole thing to present, to be honest and truthful to the original tradition. See there, one of the worst thing happened to the Hindu mythologies, even the word mythology is wrong. Hindu Puranas is, it was understood by the Western angle, through the Western historians' eyes. Constantly we are being disrespected, abused, blamed, saying they don't have a meaning, they are just fantasies and all that. Max Muller translated Upanishads just to prove there is nothing in Upanishads. He writes in his letter, but till 90s, all our Indology scholars in India are all nothing but followers of Max Muller's. It is just last 10 years a new awakening has happened when the Sanskrit knowledge has started spreading all over the world. We were awakened to the truth. Max Mullerians cannot represent the Vedic tradition to its truth, in true form, with true respect. I tell you, Devon Ki Dev is a ripple effect of that awakening. A Purana is beautifully presented. Purana is the history written with the philosophical explanations. History with the philosophical footnotes is Purana. So, Devan Ki Dev people, the producers and directors and story writers, the whole team is really true to the concept of Purana. Purana is not just history. Purana is history with the understanding of philosophy. Incidents recorded with the big picture of philosophical understanding. With the understanding of the big picture, when incidents are recorded, that is called Purana. If the facts are recorded like everyday newspaper, it is called history. We Indians know only how to write Puranas. We are not newspaper guys. Devan Ki Dev is really doing honest and true service to the Vedic tradition. I don't see even a trace of Max Müllerianism in Devan Ki Dev. They are truly, honestly reviving. Especially the people who are supporting their philosophy team, Devdutt Bhattnayak, what a beautiful job they are doing. I wanted to specially mention his name, Devdutt Bhattnayak, for doing amazing research and supporting. The whole serial is presented in such a beautiful way. All the concepts of an incarnation, why even an incarnation needs tapas, everything is so beautifully presented to a common man. So many questions you guys ask me. Swamiji, you are an incarnation. Why did you do it to do tapas? Parvati is an incarnation. She is doing tapas. All these difficult questions, they are presenting it so beautifully to the whole mass. That is the beauty. Visually, they are able to present. And I recommend everybody to enjoy it.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्
Let you all see, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explore in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyanapitam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562109. Contact 0974220331. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.